Timing recovery using RWF. The most commonly used TRLs in existing wireless and satellite communications systems are DFS-DRL, early and late gate, digital transition tracking, and delay and multiply TRLs. For mobile environments, these TRLs drop lock when the loop signal-to-noise ratio, SNR, is smaller than the threshold value SNR or the residual Doppler frequency is larger than the operating loop bandwidth. When dropped lock, these timing loops experience a long hang-up time due to reacquisition and locking behavior of the timing clock. As discussed in Section 2.3 on the related works for DFS-DRL, a form of digital RWF was proposed for use with square TRL. This DFS-DRL suffers squaring loss caused by squaring mechanism used by the loop. This section explores the advanced TRL using RWF. The RWF-TRL concept derived from the following principles. Principle 1, input binary signal waveform is compared in time with locally generated and suitably delayed timing pulses to produce lead/lag signals to increment/decrement a timing counter. Principles 2, when timing counter output exceeds a positive or negative threshold, the delay for timing pulses is adjusted accordingly. Principle 3, without timing errors, an appropriately selected threshold value allows the lead and lag signals to cancel out in time, thus retaining the correct timing pulses. Principle 1, input binary signal waveform is compared in time with locally generated and suitably delayed timing pulses to produce lead/lag signals to increment/decrement a timing counter. Principles 2, when timing counter output exceeds a positive or negative threshold, the delay for timing pulses is adjusted accordingly. Principle 3, without timing errors, an appropriately selected threshold value allows the lead and lag signals to cancel out in time, thus retaining the correct timing pulses. The block diagram, shown in, describes the above principles pictorially. The received binary data is a square wave with amplitude varying between +1 and -1 with time duration t in second, which is inversely proportional to the communication data bit rate r in bit per second. RWF concept for timing recovery. The major software blocks, SWB, required for implementing the above three principles are SWB1, pulse detection and comparison block converts input baseband digital signal waveform to data transition pulses and compares them to timing pulses to generate lead/lag signals. SWB2, RWF counter block generates a running count that is incremented/decremented by the lead/lag signals. SWB3, threshold comparison block generates exceedance signal when magnitude of running count is greater than a selected threshold. SWB4, timing pulse delay adjustment block uses sign of running count to adjust timing pulses when triggered by exceedance signal. SWB1, pulse detection and comparison block converts input baseband digital signal waveform to data transition pulses and compares them to timing pulses to generate lead/lag signals. SWB2, RWF counter block generates a running count that is incremented/decremented by the lead/lag signals. SWB3, threshold comparison block generates exceedance signal when magnitude of running count is greater than a selected threshold. SWB4, timing pulse delay adjustment block uses sign of running count to adjust timing pulses when triggered by exceedance signal. Presents a software architecture for implementation of the three principles described in section 4.1. The threshold value is derived based on a threshold selection process that depends on the channel environment. Either a training sequence or a priori knowledge of the channel propagation conditions may be needed to set the threshold. Alternatively, an algorithm can be provided to adaptively select a threshold value to compensate for channel impairments. Software architecture of advanced TRL using RWF describes the pulse detection and comparison block, or SWB1. This SWB1 consists of the following functions. Converts input baseband digital signal waveform to data transition pulses delayed by half of the search window size, W. Generates timing pulses that are delayed by the adjusted timing pulse delay that is input to the block. Counts number of data transition pulses that are within W from each successive timing pulse and keep track of the delay of the first data transition pulse. Calculates lead/lag time of the first data transition pulse as the delay time minus half of the search window size, and lead/lag signal as the sign of the lead/lag time. outputs a non-zero lead slash lag signal if there is one, and only one, data transition pulse within the search window, thus eliminating much of the noise-caused ambiguity. Converts input baseband digital signal waveform to data transition pulses delayed by half of the search window size, W, generates timing pulses that are delayed by the adjusted timing pulse delay that is input to the block. Counts number of data transition pulses that are within W from each successive timing pulse and keep track of the delay of the first data transition pulse. Calculates lead slash lag time of the first data transition pulse as the delay time minus half of the search window size, and lead slash lag signal as the sine of the lead slash lag time. Outputs a non-zero lead slash lag signal if there is one, and only one, data transition pulse within the search window, thus eliminating much of the noise-caused ambiguity. SWB1 implementation of pulse detection and comparison. Signal processing work, SPW, implementation of the proposed RWF TRL for 8PS game modem is described in. The proposed implementation includes the following blocks. 8PS gate transmitter block generates signals modulated by sine and cosine waveforms. AWGN generator block adds Gaussian random noise to the 8PS gate signals. Demodulator with ideal phase tracking converts the 8PS gate signals to baseband. Combination of low-pass filter, LPF, and hard limiter generates a binary data stream from the 8PS gate signals. RWF TRL block generates clock signals, timing pulses. Some dump and hold block uses the clock signals to integrate the baseband 8PS gate signals. 8PS gate detector puts the integrated signals through 8PS gate slicer to reconstruct the data stream. SER estimator compares the original data stream with the reconstructed data stream to detect symbol errors. 8PS gate transmitter block generates signals modulated by sine and cosine waveforms. AWGN generator block adds Gaussian random noise to the 8PS gate signals. Demodulator with ideal phase tracking converts the 8PS gate signals to baseband. Combination of low-pass filter, LPF, and hard limiter generates a binary data stream from the 8PS gate signals. RWF TRL block generates clock signals, timing pulses. Some dump and hold block uses the clock signals to integrate the baseband 8PS gate signals. 8PS gate detector puts the integrated signals through 8PS gate slicer to reconstruct the data stream. SER estimator compares the original data stream with the reconstructed data stream to detect symbol errors. Simulation setup for 8PS gate modem with RWF TRL. SPW simulated SER curve with imperfect timing recovery is shown in. This SER curve was obtained under the following operational conditions, which is not optimized in terms of search window and threshold value used by the counter. Back-to-back modem with no transponder or amplifier in between, i.e., no amplitude modulation to amplitude modulation, AM-AM, and amplitude modulation to phase modulation, AM-PM, distortions. Carrier frequency, 5000 Hz. Symbol rate, 1000 SBS. Number of samples per symbol, 50. Search window size, 10 samples. Threshold for counter, 10 counts. Back-to-back modem with no transponder or amplifier in between, i.e., no amplitude modulation to amplitude modulation, AM-AM, and amplitude modulation to phase modulation, AM-PM, distortions. Carrier frequency, 5000 Hz. Symbol rate, 1000 SBS. Number of samples per symbol, 50. Search window size, 10 samples. Threshold for counter, 10 counts. 8PS gate symbol error rate simulation with RWF TRL. For symbol SNR greater than 2 dB, the theoretical SER for 8PS gate can be accurately estimated from the following. Where is gamma S the symbol SNR and QX is the Q function given by. As shown in. The simulated SER curve for 8PS gate with perfect phase tracking and timing recovery coincides with the theoretical SER curve for 8PS gate. Simulated SER curve with imperfect timing, but perfect phase tracking, shows a symbol SNR degradation of about 0.2 dB from the theoretical curve.